So back when we started talking about the whole numbers, we talked a little bit about integers. We defined what an integer was, but now we're actually going to get deeper into them. So just to refresh your memory, if we have the real numbers, so we have all the numbers from negative 3, all the way from negative infinity to negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, all the way to infinity. We said that all the numbers greater than 0 are called the natural numbers, and we already talked a little bit about those. We said all the numbers 0 and greater are called the whole numbers, and that's what we spent the last chapter doing, which is talking about the whole numbers in general. And then we said everything else, including the negative numbers, those are called the integers. So in this section, we're going to introduce the integers, and essentially in this whole chapter, we're going to be talking about integers. So before we get a little bit deeper into it, let's talk about what an integer is useful for. So let's say you have something like, before we get into that, hold on. Let me just quickly say a couple of things. Whenever you see a negative number, a negative sign in front of a number, that means that that number is to the left of zero on the number line. When we don't have a number in front or a sign in front of the number, that's assumed to be a positive one, and we can just leave the sign out. And then the other thing is that zero is neither negative nor positive. So now that we know that, we can use signed numbers, and a signed number is simply a number that has the sign in front of it, either a negative or a positive, to represent some situations. So one of the situations we want to represent is consider the following problem. A deep sea diver is 836 feet below the surface of the ocean. And they're asking us to represent the position using an integer. Okay, we're talking below the surface here, so if we have consider the ocean. So this is the ocean right here, part of the ocean. And we have that a deep sea diver is 836 feet below the surface. So here's your diver. And here's the surface. And he is 836 feet below the surface. So 836 feet below the surface. Because we're talking below the surface, we're going to use a negative number to represent this situation, so it's going to be a negative 836 feet. And that would be my integer. That's my signed number that represents the situation. And you can think of a whole bunch of situations like this. Say if a company lost money, we would represent it as negative numbers, things like that. One of the things you might be asked to do in this section is to graph an integer. So let's say we're asked to graph the following integers, for example. Let's say we're asked to graph the integers negative 4, negative 1, 2, and negative 2 on the number line. Well, first we're going to draw out a number line. Remember, this is what a number line looks like. And a number line goes on to infinity in both directions, on the left and on the right. But we're only going to represent a part of that number line. We're going to represent negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth. It keeps on going, right? So if I want to graph the first number, negative 4, all I'm simply going to do is plop a 0 on negative 4. Couple of things you should know. Negative 4 is less than 0, so here's 0, it is going to be to the left of 0. And if I want to graph negative 1, that would be here. If I want to graph positive 2, that would be here. And I'm going to leave negative 2 for you to graph. One of the other things we might be asked to do in this section is to compare integers. And to compare integers, we are going to use two specific symbols. The symbols are this symbol that's called less than, this symbol that's called greater than, and then sometimes we're going to use the equal sign. And we all know what the equal sign means. The equal sign means that both numbers are equal. One thing you need to keep in mind about the less than and greater than sign, that the smaller side of the sign should always point to the small number. So here the smaller side is right here. So regardless of whether you call it a less than or a greater than, just make sure that that smaller side of the sign points to the smaller number. So let's say I'm comparing the numbers negative 4 and negative 1, and I want to know which one is smaller. Well, looking at a number line, the smaller number is always going to be farther to the left. So let's look at that example we just did in which we graphed negative 4 and negative 1. That was right here. Which one is farther to the left, negative 4 or negative 1? And it turns out that negative 4 is farther to the left. Therefore, negative 4 is smaller. So remember what I said, that the small part of the sign is always going to point to the smaller number? So I'm going to use a less than sign to represent that. Let's say I want to put a less than, greater than, or equal symbol between the numbers 0 and negative 5, the numbers negative 3 and 3, and the numbers negative 7 and negative 12. Well, if I were comparing 0 and negative 5, negative 5 would be closer to the left, so therefore negative 5 is smaller. So I'm going to use a greater than sign. Again, notice the small part of the sign is pointing to the smaller number. Between negative 3 and 3, well, negative 3 is closer to the left, so that way negative 3 is going to be smaller. And I'll leave negative 7 and negative 12 up to you to do. So you should figure out which one is smaller in that case. Okay, so now that we know about negative numbers, this brings us to a different concept that we haven't talked about yet, and that is called the absolute value concept. When you think about absolute value, a lot of you probably just think about a positive number. But we need to understand why is an absolute value a positive number. So let's start with the definition of the absolute value of a number. The absolute value of a number is simply the distance between that number and zero on the number line. And we are going to use two straight bars like this to mean absolute value. So these mean absolute value. An absolute value is actually an operation. So we're going to take the absolute value of a number the same way that we add numbers, the same way that we subtract numbers. It's an operation and it has an order. We'll talk more about what its order is in the order of operations. So let's say I wanted to do, for example, the absolute value of negative 6. I know I want the absolute value of negative 6 because I have the negative 6 inside the absolute value symbol. So what I'm really looking for here is I'm looking how to find out how many spaces there are between negative 6 and 0 on the number line. We can picture this. So here would be negative 6. Here would be 0. So here would be negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6. My drawing is a little bit out of scale. Negative 6 should actually be somewhere here. And I want to know how many spaces are there between negative 6 and 0 on the number line. That would be the absolute value of negative 6. And it turns out there are 6 spaces between negative 6 and 0 on the number line. Therefore, the absolute value of negative 6 is 6. So you have always heard that the absolute value is positive, and that makes some sense because distance is always going to be in positive numbers. When I ask you how many spaces are there between negative 6 and 0 on the number line, well, there are 6 spaces. That's why absolute value is always positive. What if I wanted the absolute value of 14? I'm asking how many spaces are there between 14 and 0 on the number line? There are 14 spaces. What is the absolute value of negative 12? And always think in your head, how many spaces are there between negative 12 and 0 on the number line? And there are 12 spaces. Another thing I want you to keep in mind is that there is a difference between absolute value. An absolute value uses the bars, and between parentheses. Parentheses are not straight. Absolute values are. So they mean different things. The absolute value of a number is when I want to find the distance between that number and zero on the number line. Parentheses just mean I want to do that first. So let's talk about the opposite of a number. So say I wanted to find, the opposite of 4. What I'm really asking here is I'm asking, well, here's 0, here's 4, what other number is 0 places away from 4, and that would, or 4 places away from 0, and that would be negative 4. So the opposite of 4 is negative 4. So the opposite of a number is a number that's the same distance away from 0. From 0 on the number line. Okay, so say I wanted you to find the opposite of 5. Well, remember that negative, I'm just talking about the opposite of 5. The opposite of 5 would be negative 5. Now, what do you think would be the opposite of negative 5? This symbol right here means opposite of. So the opposite of negative 5 would be positive 5. And this brings me to a rule that we call the double negative rule. We're going to be using this a lot. So it's a good idea to keep this in mind. And the double negative rule, also called the opposite rule, is that when we have the opposite of a negative number A, we can just turn that into positive A. And if you recall, a positive number, we can just leave the positive sign out, so it would just be A. So we call that the double negative rule. So let's practice a little bit with that. Let's practice between the opposite of a number and the absolute value of a number, and the difference between those two. So let's make a table, numbers, and one side we're going to write down the numbers, another side we're going to write the absolute value of the number, and on the last column we are going to write the opposite of the number. So let's write the numbers 5, negative 3, 0, 27, negative 11. Okay, so if I wanted to find the absolute value of 5, I am going to write this like that. And the absolute value of 5, well, that's just asking me how many spaces are there between 5 and 0 on the number line. And it turns out there are 5 spaces. If I want to know the opposite of 5, well, that's just the opposite of the number 5. The opposite of the number 5 is the number negative 5. Okay, now I want to know the absolute value of negative 3. The absolute value of negative 3 is 3, because there are 3 spaces between negative 3 and 0 on the number line. And if I wanted to find the opposite of negative 3, well, this uses the double negative rule. The double negative rule says that two opposites together give me a positive 3. If I wanted to find the absolute value of 0, that tells me how many spaces are there between 0 and 0 on the number line. And there are 0 spaces between 0 and 0. And finally, I want to find the opposite of 0. Remember I said that 0 is neither negative nor positive. So the opposite of 0 is just going to be 0. I'm going to leave the last two for you to work on. So you should find the absolute value of 27 and of negative 11, and also their opposites. So now that we know the differences between opposites and absolute values, let me also give you some other examples for you to try on. Some practice problems you can try on. So let's say I wanted to find, simplify the following problems. A, the opposite of the absolute value of negative 7. And think about the way that I'm reading this. I'm reading this a specific way because it means something. So the opposite of the absolute value of negative 7. I'll try that with you. So the opposite of the absolute value of negative 7. Let's start with the absolute value of negative 7. The absolute value of negative 7 is 7. And the opposite sign just came along. And the opposite of 7 is just negative 7. So you see, that makes some sense. I'll leave the rest for you to try out. So I also want you to find the opposite of the absolute value of 14. And I want you to find the opposite of negative 12. And I want you to evaluate, this is C, evaluate the opposite of the absolute value of x when x is negative 6. So be careful, you have more than one negative sign here, so be careful when you're plugging that in. And I'll leave those for you to try out. You can ask about them in class if you still don't get it.